Today, we're exploring the world of the MECHA C2 and panoramic photography using the version 3.2.13 user guide. Let's see what the C2 can do. It's not just about simplifying panoramas, it's about opening up a whole new level of precision and creativity for photographers. The C2 controller has advanced technology behind it. What really stands out is the dual-axis control. Being able to program two rotators simultaneously, especially when combined with the scripting features, is like having a robotic arm for your camera. Also, the OLED display can guide you through all the major operations and settings. Let's first talk about the two operating modes. The C2 user's guide is divided into two parts, simple mode and advanced mode. The first part is all about getting you comfortable with the basics, while in the second part, we present more advanced features. This is where the C2's scripting language comes into play, letting you choreograph every single aspect of your shoot. There is also a menu option called simple mode that alternates with advanced mode, and it is important to note that we assume the C2 controller operates in simple mode throughout the first part of the user guide. The main difference between simple and advanced mode options is that in simple mode, you cannot exit OLED menus. This functionality prevents mistakes like commanding MECHA to perform actions accidentally. Speaking of precision, the guide recommends testing the C2 without a camera first. It's all about getting a feel for how the C2 behaves in different situations before you even think about bringing a camera into the mix. This way, you're not just controlling the C2, you're anticipating its every move. The guide also suggests checking the battery level and even setting a low battery warning. Imagine you're halfway through shooting an incredible multi-row panorama and your battery just dies. Having that low battery warning is like having a safety net. So plan for the epic shots, but be ready for anything. Power management is key for this kind of photography. The C2 uses an external battery, 9 to 19 volts, which gives you up to 8 hours of shooting. Using an external battery means you can carry spare batteries and quickly refuel MECHA before or during a shooting session. A power cable splitter is available for using two sets of batteries at the same time for extended operation and changing batteries without a pause. You don't need to be out in the field stressing about your battery dying mid-shoot. Before you get too far ahead with all the complex features, it's essential to master the basics, understand simple rotations, button combinations, and upper rail positions. Once you've got those down, everything else becomes so much easier. You're not thinking about the buttons anymore, freeing you up to be more creative. The buttons on the controller can directly control the horizontal and vertical axes of your panoramic head. If you want to make an adjustment, say 45 degrees, there's a button combination for that. You'll be surprised how quickly those button combinations become second nature. When launching a preset, the upper rail of your panoramic head should normally be in one of these positions, parked, level, or raised. You can easily achieve this using simple rotations. Updating MECHA's firmware is as easy as it gets. In the first part, we present the method of updating the firmware using a hotspot. Presets are going to be your new friend, especially when you're out there shooting and time is precious. So instead of manually entering settings every single time, you just call a preset, and you're ready to go. You can create presets to match your own vision. Using the OLED menu, you can adjust the number of shots you want to take, or specify the focal length, the number of camera trigger signals per position, image overlap, rows and tilts, position of the upper rail, direction of rotation, zenith and nadir shots, and many others. The guide keeps mentioning zenith and nadir shots. Imagine a giant snow globe, so the zenith is the very top of the globe and the nadir is the very bottom. When we talk about panoramas capturing those specific points, it ensures that you end up with a truly complete 360-degree sphere. MECHA can also compute a preset for your lens even if you don't know the exact focal length. Remember that dual axis control we talked about earlier? Well, you can actually use that to physically define a partial panorama, a panorama within specific boundaries. It's incredibly useful, especially for those really tricky shots where you're working in a tight space or only want to capture a very specific field of view. That takes creative control to a whole new level. The C2's got a nice library of presets built right in, the factory presets. Each one's tailored for different lenses. And the best part? You can customize every single one of them using the user interface. The OLED config menu is a quick alternative to the more complex configuration page in the user interface. Here you can find about 80 options with just a few button presses. The C2 handles a lot of settings automatically in the background, so you can just focus on the bigger picture, literally. MECHA controllers can also be used to control movement along a linear rail and in turntable applications. We recommend watching this video about rotating a turntable using the MECHA C2 controller. The user interface gives you even more control. Imagine being able to adapt any preset to your needs and command MECHA from your phone or tablet. You can also access the user interface using a computer connected to a wireless network. The two-axis slider, available only in complexity levels A3 and S3 of the user interface, is a tool that allows you to perform common rotations and specify the extent of partial panoramas by setting the top left and lower right corners. Many subjects mentioned in this user guide are detailed and covered in videos, such as settings for bracketed photos, shutter release confirmation basics, tilt and number of positions versus pitch and yaw. MECHA automatically generates a script and you provide a focal length instead of the number of shots. MECHA's simple scripting, or MSS, is a powerful tool for photographers interested in complex shooting patterns. MECHA's user interface can be easily translated into another language. This feature can also be used to add notes to the existing descriptions of user interface controls. Many settings on the configuration page have equivalents on the OLED config menu. For example, you can set MECHA to access point, station, AP plus STA, or no Wi-Fi on both the OLED config menu and the configuration page in the user interface. Other common settings include rotator settings. Use Nodal Ninja IR remote. Check this checkbox to enable the use of the NNIR remote control. You must also connect the receiver to the MECHA's AUX port. Camera settings. Arrow button speeds and intervals. Battery min and battery max. Simple mode, and many others. Another way to program a preset is by passing parameters into a URL. MECHA adds the new preset to the list of presets and also assigns it to some controller buttons, allowing you to launch the preset easily and quickly. This way, you can create presets for single and multi-row panoramas and partial panoramas. When using the user interface, you can tweak any preset to match your own vision. You can even add pauses for things like changing your exposure, fine-tuning your focus, changing the lens, or taking extra shots. It's all about making the C2 work the way you want it to, not the other way around. A preset you create on the user interface can be listed on the OLED menu as well, and vice versa. MECHA's simple scripting, MSS, is how you go from taking panoramas to conducting them. Actually, you only need to provide the focal length, and MECHA writes the script for you. Then you can adapt the script to your needs. For example, instead of a single zenith, more zeniths may be needed, say, for flare reasons. Consider adding focus and extra shot positions. You may also need a pause, such as before a horizontal row or before nadir, to ensure you are out of the camera's field of view. Shoot a partial panorama for checking before shooting a full 360-degree one. Rewind after each row, useful when cables to a power bank are used. Shoot in a zigzag pattern, as an alternative to normal. During a pause, you can also change the lens or focal length. And many other variations are possible. The script type can be either PY, pitch and yaw conventions, or TXN, tilt and number of positions for each tilt. A preset can be launched using a button combination, from the OLED menu, from the user interface, and also by scanning a QR code. Out of the box, MECHA operates in AP mode. Since it does not have a wireless modem, it does not have internet access. A device connected to it may also lose internet access. But there is a way to set both MECHA and your smartphone for internet access, as explained in the user guide. As we have already mentioned, MECHA can compute a shooting pattern, or preset, based on a few button presses without using the user interface. Speaking of buttons, you can enter codes to perform some operations using the controller buttons in advanced mode only. C2 users don't need to use codes too much, though. For example, to find out the firmware version, you can use the code 3212, or alternatively, you can select the firmware version option from the OLED config menu on page 8. Speaking of advanced, the guide mentions something called S-Language 2. Think of S-Language as a specialized dialect of MSS. It's specifically made for super complex, multi-row panoramas. So if you are just starting out, stick with MSS. You may never need to read about S-Language. But if you want to be a panorama master, S-Language is the next step. The guide eases you into both. Start simple, then get trickier. Plus, the C2 itself is pretty intuitive once you get going. Experiment, make your own scripts, see what happens. You will feel less like a photographer and more like a panorama composer. The C2 is our second generation of controllers, equipped with an OLED display and external battery, while the single-axis C1 has LED indicators only and a built-in battery. Two C1 controllers can be assembled in a dual-axis combo configuration to control two axes, just like the C2 controller. Besides other methods of controlling MECHA, there is also a raw interface, which allows third-party applications and any user to control MECHA through a series of parameters and commands presented in the chapter with the same name. You need to connect to MECHA's Wi-Fi network using your phone or computer, as usual. The raw interface can also be accessed via serial communication using the MECHA's USB port. Let's go one step further and talk a bit about chains of cloned MECHAs. Imagine multiple C2s, each running its own set of rotators, but all working together perfectly in sync to capture a complex panorama. So instead of just one C2, you could have many of them, all working on your masterpiece. And the best part? It's all wirelessly controlled. You make a little network, link up your MECHAs, and suddenly you're conducting a symphony of motion. It's worth mentioning the C2 interface, which allows you to control MECHA remotely without touching the C2 controller buttons. First, connect your computer or smartphone to MECHA's Wi-Fi network. Then, go to the C2 page. MECHA's static IP address is 192.168.8.1. If you are connecting to MECHA's network using a computer, use the dynamic IP address. We've gone from the basics to chains of MECHAs, and we've just scratched the surface. So for anyone listening, don't be afraid to try things out and see what you can create. The MECHA C2 is ready when you are. Thank you for joining us for this user-friendly tour of the user guide. Until next time, happy shooting!